Hello, I'm Al Rivera, and this is How I Set Exposure. What is going on, filmmakers? Hope you and yours are well, considering the situation the country finds itself. And as we have to move on, let's get into this and let's do this. I spent the weekend with a DP. We were shooting the breeze. We ended up on exposures. I showed her how I set my exposures from A to Z. I did not record it. I should have. But hopefully you'll find this useful and you can incorporate it into your workflow. Let's begin. First of all, I would assume that you lock in all your settings the day of or the night prior to a shoot, which is usually what I do. When you come on set, the first thing you should do is begin to set up your camera and your team should light. There, my team set my lighting up. Now, I am going to frame up. Do a quick focus. There's kind of my frame. Okay, that's the, okay. So now I have a frame. Quick focus on my subject, which is the keyboard. Now I throw in my focus chart. And I use a focus chart all the time. I use a focus chart all the time. I put it right next to the product, or I put it right there next to the talent's face. Now I'm kind of in focus. I'm gonna go to the T-stop that I'm gonna use. On this, I'm going to use 2.8. Now I recheck my focus. I like focusing wide open. It's very precise. There, I'm in focus. I turn my focus chart around because the opposite side is a white balance card. I'm going to turn on the zebra to my GH5 that I have it set at 80. And I'm now going to adjust the lighting accordingly. It is a slightly overexposed. I'll bring the lighting intensity down. There you go. Now my zebra's showing around 75, 77. I'm done with the white. At this point, I have a tendency to throw gray cards around at different points on the set, and I'm gonna do that now. Now, once I've kind of done this, I have a habit of doing that. Sometimes I even put more. I take my white balance card. I bring it right up to the camera. And I go click, 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 and I get my white balance. In this case, I had done it prior. So therefore, I didn't move it. Now, everything is kind of in place for me to begin to finalize my exposure. 95% of the time I use false color, and 95% of the time my only concern are the black levels in the image. For a GH5, I would recommend, if you're shooting log, do not let the blacks fall under 25. If you're shooting on a red camera, I do not let the blacks go below 30. And if you're shooting on any Alexa, I do not let the blacks go below 20. Remember, the GH5 and the GH5S. I know that the GH5S allegedly has more range, whatever they claim. I still do not like it to go under 25, especially with log. I find the log profile noisy. Night exteriors are noisy with a log profile. I find it cleaner with the 8 bits on a Cine D. Got it? Now I'm going to turn on the false colors and we're going to continue from there. Just turned it on my Ninja. Now let me turn it on the Sumo. Now please note, as I said prior, false color is my main exposure tool. Therefore, once all this is done and it's all in place and art department has finished and I think I'm getting ready to sign off on the lighting and the levels of the light, because I do not change my T-stop, I now come in with my meter. And now you're looking at my meter. This is a photo vision. I think I purchased this at B&H, but I'm not sure. And I want to bring your attention to the Sumo, and I just want you to take 30 seconds and look at the Sumo, and I'll stay quiet. Okay, I'm back. That humming noise that you hear is actually the fan on the Sumo, believe it or not. Notice, that is where I place all my attention. That black part has a false color indication of green, meaning that area is falling between 44 and 47 IRE. Look up at the gray. The gray is falling above 55. And then look up at the white. It's in the 60s to 70s, which is where I want it. I definitely want it there. But let's go back to the black. I can actually live with this image the way it is right now, because if you look at my gray card in the back, that's the same level as the black in front. This is why I have that. And look at the right side. You could see my gray and my white are exactly the same color. You could see that. That's what's indicating to me what's going on. I'm going to move the gray cards again. Now I could see a difference between the gray, the little gray card, and the white, and it just shows me different things. Notice that these two are the same. And I'm pretty happy with this, but I still want to just lower the intensity a little and get that green off of that black part. Watch the Sumo. There we go. There we go. There it is. That's it, my exposure set. My exposure set. I'm gonna take this false color off. At least I'll try. Take this out. Clean that up. Take this out and I'm ready to shoot. This comes out. Only one thing that I had to check, just because I'm rushing for you, I'm putting this white directly under the spotlight, excuse me. And then I'm gonna check, I put the white directly under the card to check for the zebra, but it is fine. At this point, my AC would come in with the slate and a chip chart. I would call it, we would mark it, blah, 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 take one. At this point, right before my AC marks it, I once again check my focus. Sometimes I actually have the AC hold the focus chart in again with the slate and the chip chart. We shoot it. Now I have my clip. My AC walks away with this. And we call action.